It's a great conference. It's the second time in a row, second year in a row that I attended. It's a long way from home. I counted 20 hours door to door, but it's well worth it. It's a great opportunity for us to exchange views with other participants from different parts of the world, particularly as China has been developing, changing very rapidly. And so is Africa. And there is no substitute for face-to-face contacts, exchanging views, debating issues. So I'm all for it. And I very much look forward to coming back again next year. The theme of our session was globalization, the Chinese position. The message I wanted to impart on the audience and on the conference as a whole is that globalization is a trend. There is no turning back because it is, by and large, in the final analysis, beneficial to everyone in the world. China supports globalization, not just because of the Chinese government's position, which obviously supports globalization, but also because the Chinese people welcome globalization. For 2,000-3,000 years, the Chinese people are firstly travelers wide and far, in those days on the back of camels and treasure boats and so on. But at the same time, they also welcome friends from other parts of the world to come to China. China, by and large, in a 3,000-4,000 years of history, has been a borderless country. If you look at some of the things that happen in our daily lives, the most popular religion in China is Buddhism, which is not indigenous, it's imported. Some of the musical instruments that we regard as traditional Chinese musical instruments were actually imported from different parts of the world outside of the so-called Middle Kingdom in ancient times. So we go out and we also welcome people from different parts of the world, different walks of life to come to China. Our experience shows that it enriches our life. It isn't just a question of assisting economic growth. So that's not just the Chinese government's position, it's also Chinese people's position. You've looked at how in recent years Chinese outbound tourism has grown. Last year, 3.4% of the 1.4 billion Chinese people in China travel to a foreign country. This is not counting Hong Kong, Macau and Taiwan, which are part of China. So China is not just a source of tourism. The fact that we have 3.4% of the Chinese population leaving country, going to other countries to have a look-see, really underlines the fact that the Chinese people are interested in seeing what lives are about in different parts of the world, and also exchanging their views and their opinions and experiences in life. That's globalization. In the end, I firmly believe in this. In the end, it's nobody else. It's the people who make history. Globalization is now an unstoppable mega trend. You may have ebbs and flows, you may have pushbacks, you may have resistance on terms of a trade deal, but these are just the ebbs and flows. The mega trend is globalization, and it's not stoppable. It's not up to a president of a country to say, I want to stop globalization, because with the advent of technology that can move people, goods, capital, and information in bigger volumes, in faster and cost-effective ways, you have globalization. And so I don't think it's a question of the US position on climate change or on the trade deals with China that could stop or even reverse globalization. And in the final analysis, we have to emphasize on the importance of the enterprising spirit of mankind in pushing globalization forward. African countries have, as we heard the Ethiopian minister spoke at my session. There is a need on their part for inward investment, manufacturers from China, and also infrastructure investments. China doesn't have insatiable appetite, and definitely does not have insatiable capacity or unlimited capacity to invest. And the Belt and Road Initiative is an initiative for international cooperation. So it's a bilateral thing. It's not just a question of what the Chinese want to do or they don't want to do, and by the same token, what African countries want to do or don't want to do.